good day. This is the Stepping Razor, the Art of War. We there with you. We there with you, yes. And next Thursday, we give thanks for the moment, give thanks for the time, give thanks to all the people who sit up with me till 2 o'clock last night, yes. Because remember, I was sitting up with you, no. So, we continue the journey. We continue the journey because, you know, say, it's a different kind of program, this. Believe you me, we not only play music, but we give voice to the voiceless and expressions. And we don't only talk, but we also play music. Brand new.
Overcome others' armies without fighting is the best of skills. Best of skills.
The art of war.
Sipping. Razor.
Dangerous.
Forward.
I'm like a stepping razor. Don't you watch my sides? I'm dangerous. Dangerous. I'm like a stepping razor. Don't you watch my side? I'm dangerous.
Stepping razor. Mucha baruca. Art of war. Listen, Jamaica. And this is the art of war. Sing it, sing it. Representing from our family. The blood of African kings run up in our veins. Here in Jamaica, rebellious offspring. Muta got a warrior spirit inside. From that time, we chant him. And this a warrior spirit inside. It come from break every shackle and chain. When the Shaka Zulu, Pitney, Nkrumah, Pitney, Stepping Razor, Pitney. And the art of war every Thursday. Hey, look how many years them whip with. That's what the whip I want my crutches with. We tell them Babylon style and fit with. War it out until we get to a victory. Hey, them fight my brother and sister. When we are dancing, them say we move sinister. I know we're listening. Muta Baruka, chant the culture, chase the vultures away. Mana Shaka Zulu, Pitney, Nkrumah, Pitney, Kunta Kinte, Pitney. It's like Malcolm and Martin and Marcus and Fiery. Taurus is here and I represent for Muta Baruka. The art of war, sure, Rasta.
When a youth fails, it's always put down to personal problems. But one cannot ignore the social system and the effect it can have on an individual. It's all about the youth. It's all about the youth. The youth them of today. Their role in this society, the part they're gonna play. It's all about the youth. The youth them of today. The future for tomorrow, they have to lead the way. Too much unemployment, too much violence and the crime. Too much our youths are in a prison doing time. Not enough in the colleges and universities. Not enough for them to do, not enough activities. Our youths have so much energy, so much vitality. If it's channeled in the right direction, how great they could be. But they face a lot of problems in this society. And it's supposed to be a land of equal opportunity. It's just the other day, them get to realize racism in society is institutionalized. It took the murder of a black youth to open up their eyes. equal opportunities. Is it a pack of lies? It's all about the youths, the youth them of today. Their role in this society, the part they're gonna play. It's all about the youth them of today. The future for tomorrow, they have to lead the way. Make we look into the schools, we youths not do so well. Enough of them I get suspended and I get expelled. When they finish primary school, they were doing very well. Them come out of the secondary, just about and spell. When it comes to sport, the youth get enough support. Athletics on the football pitch and also on the court. But then you will find, when it comes to the youth, their mind. All of a sudden some teachers don't have enough time. Our youths are as intelligent as everybody else. At school they are not really taught no knowledge of themselves. They are categorized and thrown upon the shelf. They're left with only certain choices of obtaining wealth. It's all about the youths, the youth them of today. Their role in this society, the part they're gonna play. It's all about the youth them of today. The future for tomorrow, they have to lead the way. Go to get a job that is well paid. Suddenly they find out that they just don't have a grade. Lack of qualifications can bring them misery. They have to do some packing in a dirty factory. The bosses start to talk to them like they're a little child. The youths them, they don't like it and their blood it starts to boil. Disrespect and racial insults get the youth them mad. Tell the boss about himself and where to stick his job. We need some more role models, some more black business.
Yes, good day. This is the Stepping Razor, the Art of War. We're there with you on next Thursday. The year is closing up. Yes, the year is closing up. And now is the rush time for things. This is the time of the year when things take precedence over everything. Things, material things. These are the things that make December what December is. Someone institutionalized things season under the mask of Christmas. They institutionalized a time when people go out there and hustle and scuffle for things. So things is the order of the day. Things is the order of the last part of the year when we all go out there to try to get things. Some things is what we need. Because, you know, sometimes you have some things and it get run down and old, so you have to go really get them back. But most of the times, this time of the year, it's things that you don't really need. You just didn't want it. And now, because this is the time of things, you decide, say, well, you're going to get it. So, why you love all the people them who search for things? You love all the people them who search for things? And who knows, say, you have certain things that make them life more meaningful and more purposeful, because not all things is bad. You have good things. And sometimes, this is the time when your mind tell you, say, well, you have to get that thing, you know. Because my birthday, I come up here and I feel like I should get certain things. Whether somebody give me it or me get it for myself. But I feel like certain things make me feel more happy. You understand? Like all my music. I feel like my music make me feel good. So, you know, I feel like food make me feel good. So, you know, say, things is not necessarily a bad thing. But when you start to exceed your limits, then you know you're going in a some serious problem. Stepping Razor, we're there with Neil. In the studio with you. Nomad. Nomad.
girl dress. Now sorry about ganja that me keeping on my brain. My cologne is made of fame, so I'm Alex Ganja Stain. Alex Ganja Stain. Alex Ganja Stain.
I'm always Ganja Stain.
Sly and Rob represent Nomads. Yeah, Ganja Stain.
Always Ganja Stain. Always Ganja Stain. Ganja Stain. Ganja Stain.
RFM, number one radio station in the whole wide world. In Nigeria.
Radio.
Selassie. From King Street to Parade. Loot and fire. Hustlers string out on the street. Fire burn. You tell the food to eat. Oh, every juvenile wants a gun. Young girls don't can keep on with the fun. But I just a dumb song run. I just a dumb song run. No man to the damn informer pay dumb. Can a man applaud when police wanna come? Say I just a dumb song run. The youth say I just a dumb song run. Say bills and rent them things we can't stand. Where them expect from an uncat man. Same one room bikini, man and woman. You know see them a fi make bread out of sand. Anyone fi get the money from fi pay fi education. We sell bag juice in a sun at Villang. White car glass out of gas station. That is operation. Oh, every juvenile wants a gun. Young girls don't can keep on for the fun. I just a dumb dumb one. I just a dumb dumb one. No man to the damn informer pay dumb. Can a man a plan when police wanna come? Say I just a dumb dumb one. The youth say I just a dumb dumb one. Hey, say take this one to the media. Politician are the biggest here a leader. Say a them buy the guns. And them sell the drugs and them not give the youths them no visa. Mrs. X, Dodos, Flaka and Tesha. Them bear the pressure for me never seen no better. Politician youths them no run with gun prisoner. That's why me pick up brother Miguel and Muta. Oh, every juvenile want a gun. Young girls don't can keep on for the fun. But I just a dumb dumb gun. I just a dumb dumb gun. No money to the damn informer.
Thought provoking, always smoking, lyrics like a bazooka. You are listening to Muta Baruka.
Selassie, from King Street to Parade, loot and fire. Hustlers string out on the street. Fire burn, you tell the food to eat. Oh, every juvenile man a gun. Young girl
fun, but I just a dumb dumb gun. I just a dumb dumb gun. Your man to the dining farm appear dumb. Ghana man a plan when police man a come. Say I just a dumb dumb gun. The youth say I just a dumb dumb gun. Say bills and rent them thing we can't stand. Where them expect from an uncat man. See him one room bikini, man a woman. You know see them a fi make bread out a sand. Anyway fi get the money from fi pay fi education. We sell bag juice in a sun at Philang. White car glass out a gas station. I get a disoperation mode. Every juvenile want a gun. Young girls don't can keep a in the fun. But I just a dumb dumb gun. I just a dumb dumb gun. Your man to the dining farm a pay dumb. Ghana man a plan when police man a come. Say I just a dumb dumb gun. The youth say I just a dumb dumb gun. Hey, say take this one to the media. Politician and the biggest era leader. Say I them buy the guns. I them sell the drugs. And them not give the youth them no visa. Misfits, dodos, flaka and Tesha. Them be all the pressure but me never seen no better. Politician use them on the runway gun prisoner. That's why me big up brother Miguel Amuta. Oh, every juvenile want a gun. Young girls don't can't keep on for the fun. But I just a dumb dumb gun. I just a dumb dumb gun. Your man to the dining farm a pay dumb. Ghana man a plan when police man a come. Say I just a dumb dumb gun. The youth say I just a dumb dumb gun. Say bills and rent them thing we can't stand. Where them expect from man and cat man. See a man room bikini, man a woman. You know see them a fi make bread out a sand. Anyway fi get the money from fi pay fi education. We sell bag juice in a sun at Philang. White car glass out a gas station. Like a dirty separation, boy. Every juvenile want a gun. Young girls don't can keep on for the fun. But I just a dumb dumb gun. I just a dumb dumb gun. No man to the dining farm a pay dumb. Ghana man a plan when police man a come. Say I just a dumb dumb gun. The youth say I just a dumb dumb gun. Hey, say take this one to the media. Politician and the biggest era leader. Say I them buy the guns. And them sell the drugs. And them not give the youth them no visa. Misfits, dodos, flaka and Tesha. Them be all the pressure but me never seen no better. Politician use them no run with gun prisoner. That's why me big up brother Miguel Amuta. Every juvenile wants a gun. Young girls don't can keep on for the fun. But I just a dumb dumb gun. I just a dumb dumb gun.
I reappear. Thought-provoking, always smoking, lyrics like a bazooka. You are listening to Muta Baruka.
Hey Pepe, Janua Star. I make sure that me let him sell nothing from morning. Better walk home, think like a run. Just bent and open at the wild in sun. Them a come, crowd up your hoods and run. Hustle man a hustle for the dinner money now. Better walk. A place sucky and the people cry cream. Me looking at the street, me say Jesus peace. Higla around me, you a do a clean free. Dem a come, Higla around. Judge Benton up in a the wild in sun. Dem a come, crowd up your hoods and run. Hustle man a hustle for the dinner money now. Me you a come, Higla around. Judge Benton up in a the wild in sun. Dem a come, crowd up your hoods and run. Hustle man a hustle for the dinner money now. The big foot me job boy, take where me bag. So I don't make sure me a run road red. At Galley, let me know I can't beg. Road me sing there, you can call me take a red. Better walk home, big la a run. Rush bent and open at the wild in sun. Them a come, crowd up your hoods and run. hustle man, I hustle for the dinner money, no. Make you walk home, see it out. Right here, panty slippers. And then me I wear. See ya, my nice big friend. Beg a buy now. 30 grand, we make that a week. Since me joke on the food night. But real hustle has not accept defeat. Why juggle your thing as food I feed? Put your shoulder to the wheel one day you have to reach. Your goal in a life, you go look back and smile. Never you forget these words for me too. Matter of fact, you better look if them are, if them are, if them are gone. Hitler around, Judge Benton up in a deep wilding sun. Them are gone, crowd where boots are run. Hustle man, I hustle for the dinner money, no.
Yeah, we want yellow parlor, sister, them down Princess Street. Oh, turn Princess Street in a them beauty parlor of Kingston. Yeah, man, me I tell you, entrepreneurship. Whether you are like it or not, it's entrepreneurship. Who are yell up all the data them from Princess Street? Who know, say, them are use them head wisely for make a money, for feed them picnic, and feed them man, and feed them man, woman. Yes. Who are yell up all of the sister them in front of the American embassy? Who knows their entrepreneurship, them are run the thing place with. And we say entrepreneurship, but that we are work with. Who knows say, when them take your phone and you give them $100, that $100 go towards feeding them picnic, feed them man, and feed them man, woman. Yes. Stepping razor, the art of war. Out of England by way of Clarendon, the future, Randy Valentine come through. This is the art of war.
It's time for the change. Oh, think hard. We got the love in the dance. Watch this. When was the last time you hear a bass line drop? And it make you feel like say you are go about the music so nice. You know that the problem. Was the last time you hear a bass line drop, and it make you feel like say you a go have a talk up. The music so nice, you would have bust a gunshot, but this let me now go bust if me no sing nothing slap. Oh gosh, the dance hall business set away, all who no turn snitch them run can't turn gain up, sell out them soul, forget radio play beat attach, must a turn in a engrave. Yo, we need a change right now, we need a change right now. Now, things that are red, we need to bring back the love again. We need to bring back the love again. You know, see these guys.
You are listening to Nuta Baruka.
You may not listen to see that them get that ready, grave them end up a prison. See where them are. That now go stop me none at all. No, them have to kill me all. Oh, we don't break any world laws. Let me write a letter first class. Tell them free world boss. And change right now. We need a change right now. The things set away right now. The things set away. We need to bring back. Great man, you see before him left the earth, he make some great songs. And unto me, every word is like a great song. And every instrumental was like a weapon. So tell me what we are waiting on. Come and quit trample every beast and every pagan. Somebody pass me the light on something.
You are listening to Muta Baruka.
It's time for the change. Oh. When was the last time you hear a bass line drop? And it make you feel like say you a go have a talk up. The music so nice, you would have bust a gunshot. But this let me now go bust if me no sing nothing slap. Oh gosh, the dance hall business set away. All who not
sell out them souls. We get radio play beat attached, most are turning out in grave. Now we need a change right now. We need a change right now. The things set away right now. The things set away. We need to bring back the love again. I'm a shop be sitting there, no one we do no music with the liquid. Them listen, any artist we try it. Them end up prison. See that them get a credit grave, and them end up a prison. See where them a do to Mojo, see where them a do to busy. That now go stop me none at all. No, them a fi kill me all. Oh, we don't reggae the world lost. Make me write a letter first class, tell them free world boss. And change right now. We need a change right now. The things set away. Before him left the earth, he make some great songs. And Anthony, every word is like a great song. And every instrumental was like a wave band. So tell me what we are waiting on. Come if we trample every beast and every pagan. Somebody pass me the light on some vegan. I make we burn them up and burn them up. As the bass one play. Yeah. Whoa. As the bass one play. Yeah. Oh. When was the last time you hear a bass line drop? And it make you feel like say you a go a bar to talk. The music so nice. You would a bust a gunshot. But it's like me now go bust if me no sing nothing slap. Oh gosh, the dance hall business set away. I do not know run can't come again. Sell out them we get ready to play beat attach. Must a turn in a engrave. Yo, we need a change right now. We need a change right now. We need to bring back the love again. We need to bring back the love again. We need to bring back the love again.
You are listening to Muta Baru.
And if you wear them like we do, and if you rub them like we do, make them do it for job. We have Rastafari, we have roots and a culture.
You are listening to Muta Baruka.
Good afternoon, I am Patrice Walters with the local and international headlines. Another wanted man was captured by the police in a joint police-military operation in Ferret District, St. Catherine, this morning. A statement from the Jamaica Defense Force says this morning's operation resulted in the detention of 10 men, including one who was wanted by the police for shooting with intent. The operation, which involved a large deployment of soldiers and police, supported by a JDF helicopter, took place at approximately 4:30 a.m. Yesterday, a wanted man was captured by police military operation at Adelvin Avenue in East Kingston. Rehabilitative work is to resume along the Kingshop to Highgate Hall main road in Manchester. The National Works Agency says the roadway is a major link between Christiana, Manchester, and heavily populated farming communities of South Trelawney. NWA Community Relations Officer for the South Region, Howard Hendricks, says works resumed yesterday and should be completed by January 10 next year. The works include removal of old asphalt, laying of new base, priming and paving with asphaltic concrete, patching and drainage improvement works. In news overseas, witnesses say a twin bomb attack has taken place in a busy area of the Nigerian city of Jos, killing at least 30 people. The two bombs exploded in quick succession close to the scene of a major bomb attack in May. Jos is a city with a mixed population of Muslims and Christians, and in recent years, suspected Boko Haram militants have attacked churches there. Finally, Brazilian police have arrested a man who has confessed to the killing of 42 people over the last decade in the city of Rio de Janeiro. Police say they arrested a man yesterday, shortly after he stabbed a woman to death in a city suburb. He then confessed to killing another 37 women, 3 men, and a 2-year-old girl. The police are searching for alleged victims and say they have already found 4.
FM, thought-provoking, always smoking, lyrics like a bazooka. You are listening to Muta Baruka.
If you're rockin' like it, like with me. with your bag of tricks. Don't take me for your foolish clown. You're on my back just like a pick, getting ready to play your tricks. Release me from yourself and throw it in the well and drop it down into the bottom of hell. For you can play no hide and seek with me. For you'll be in just for a treat. Remember, hope you die a fame fire. Get you wicked on fire. A fame fire. So I'm warning you, don't come with no folly, or you will be very sorry. Don't play no hide and seek with me now, for you'll be in just for retreat. Remember Obadiah, a famous father, catch wicked up by ya. Me father, remember Obadiah, catch your kid up by a feel me father. I hear my Obadiah, remember Obadiah, catch your kid up by a
feel me father.
Life is one big road with a lot of sign. One big road with a lot of sign. Sign and
yes, this is the Stepping Razor out there with you. We have an interview, your lineup with Christian Chafari Simpson, Finson, sorry. Whoa, yeah. What a thing. You know, say the Prime Minister be a thing, man. What is it? Chatting about me? Why, maybe, you know, why, the most of people are thinking about me Friday that day, I tell you, you know, say, it slipped out of my boy mouth last week, say, them are pants of healers, so I'm going to live a garden town. On Friday, when I hear the man say, you know, I never try to correct it, you know, all of them, I try to correct it, you know, say, you know, so you're a good boy, man. The man say, eh? Yeah, Renito say, them have me pants, them have some beer, me pants, some. I'm a part of me and family live a God, so you don't long that. You don't long that. You don't long me live a God, so that's that. From before we come for radio, you know. The man never pinpoint me from them time there. Anyway, I guess they pinpoint me still at all. So you know what I say now? We really want to talk about something with God a long time, but you know say, we no Lego things, you know. Yeah, we no really Lego things. We all lamp on things. Until things rectify. You understand? Because we need to rectify, so we can't just keep bringing up things from radio. And then after a while, we just let it go and go on for the next something. And then go on for the next something. And it's something we talk about first time to rectify. So we have to keep it to the consciousness and the mind of the people. Them certain things we bring up on this program, yeah? We have to keep it to the mind of the people, that the people them can remember. Say, but wait, how that we don't hear nothing about that again? Did it, was it rectified or was it not rectified? So one of the things them that was not rectified, we really need to talk to Mr. Finson about it, yeah. We really need to talk to him. Talk to him about it. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, how you doing?
I am quite okay, sir.
Yeah, man, long time I don't hear from you.
No, well, you know, sir, me say Tom in our story that the animal asked me about Muslim business. I don't know if I'm friend, if I'm friend at all Muslim or what.
I know that.
But yeah, because them still looking there. Them say Musa come here. Tell me something, but I ask me some question about because them still with a Lebanese man. They look like Lebanese man now answer them. Oh, them want here and I meet them call all a rat man to go talk about Muslim. So I don't know if it's some conversion going on in the place there. Eh? But it would be interesting if you see ton Muslim state.
I know that, but that's okay anyway.
All right. You hear me I say now. Suppose me pan all the radio yes or no. Get up and say, well, you know, say me know a ambassador who is a gay guy who sleep with woolly for picnic and all them something there. Nobody now gonna arrest me for that. If me say me know ambassador who do that. Somebody can arrest me. All right, even if the cab fit somebody, I'm going to say, there is an ambassador where me know, where sleep in little picnic. Nobody can arrest me feet, even if the cab fit somebody out there.
I don't think so, but I don't know if I would be able to just advise you off a cuff like that. In other words, if there are other implications by way of courier or anything like that, I wouldn't want it to be said that you relied on my information.
No, your information. Me just said that, you know. I'm not a man on the radio, you know. Me just said that. You are advising me if I'm wrong or I'm right to say it, or if I can't forget myself in that trouble. That's what I say.
Yeah, I wouldn't want it to rely on my advice.
All right.
But as far as I'm concerned, I don't see how...
I can't get myself in a problem for that.
I don't see how any criminal charge could flow from that.
All right, suppose I get up and say the same thing and then I say, instead of me say ambassador, I say Tom Strokes. You want to say Tom Strokes sleep with Wally, a man out there, you know? Wally, a little picnic out there. I could have get myself in a trouble for that, don't it? If you call a man name.
I think that you'll be opening yourself up to defamation.
Of character?
I think so.
So then would assume, they would have draw a lawsuit against me then?
I think they would have the right to do so.
Okay.
Whether they're going to do it, yes or no.
Yeah, it's our next thing.
It's our next thing because the reality would be, it would have to come down to proving these various issues, whether or not.
All right, so if we say it by the radio, and me can prove it in our court. Where it means that Moon get charged for the libelous. It wouldn't be a libel then if me can prove it. If me say a man do that, and me call him name Tom Strokes, Unka, it means that.
I think the test would more rest on them to prove that what you said is libelous.
Okay.
I don't think the test would really be you proving that what you said is in fact true.
Okay.
You would have to then prove that what you said did not affect their reputation or character.
Even if it's true. So
I think that the test would be slightly different. That is my understanding of it. Remember, I don't have any extensive experience in that particular area.
As you can appreciate,
the law has developed where they have persons who are specialists in these various areas.
All right. So I'm going to ask you the follow-up question now. Suppose a man come on the airwaves now and say, well, you want to see a man out there, I figured finger for 100 murder out there, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Where that do I mean now? The person who, if him call the person name, it means, you know, the person who name him call, have to go prove, say, not no go so. I'm going to charge the man who said so for slander him name. How that go?
If you're speaking specifically about cartel,
yeah. Well, at this moment in time, you talk about cartel, yeah, because we remember a statement that was made that there is 100 more cases where cartel is fingered in. So we want to know how that statement they work now with, like, Vibes Cartel, or if him can get a lawyer now to actually sue the person who claim that him get fingered for 100 more murder.
Well, as I understand it, he has gotten a lawyer.
Him get and a lawyer.
And the lawyer has in fact filed documents speaking specifically to that already.
Mm. So there's a case pending for that then?
That is my understanding of it. So the attorney who he would have instructed would be a civil attorney that specializes in those types of cases.
Yes.
And I understand, in fact, I did see documents that were drafted that would be in a bid to bring a case against those persons specifically.
All right, so how that did not work now? Would the person have to bring a lie, have to prove, say, this is true, that him have 100 fingered for 100 murder? How that work? Tell me how it works.
I believe that would be part of it. So the person would have to essentially come and say, yes, we have proved that this person has committed 100 murders. And in fact, when we said so, it didn't affect his character negatively or in any adverse way. That would have to be the response.
So can a man's character be affected if he's in a prison for murder?
I think his character can be affected in a circumstance where he's an appellant. Because in Abijah Palmer's specific case, he has appealed it. So I think the attorney would be arguing yes. And what you're really seeking to do is you're seeking to prejudice the outcome of his appeal.
Okay.
But I think in these circumstances, it runs even deeper in not only suggesting that you're adversely affecting his character by saying this, but you're affecting his case.
Yes.
And the long and short of it is that you're affecting his freedom.
All right. So you said that the most the problematic part of it is that him have a appeal coming up, and that would now the possibility of it affecting him appeal would be really something else. Rather than him being a citizen and saying now that this man slander him name for something where him can't prove, or maybe him can't prove it, but he must prove it.
And I think that you have to remember, Tunamuta, is that the issue of 100 murders was really only one of many statements that were made by all levels of the force. So whether it be the minister, the commissioner, or officers who were closely affiliated with the case. That statement was only really one of many statements made.
Yeah. But you see,
if you can recall.
Yeah, me know, but you see, me I try to find out if a man could have said that and really get away with that the whole Jamaica going to forget that, because the man who him said about was charged for murder. Is it that because a man charged for murder, him not have no more argument to say somebody make something prejudice him name, or him have a right now to defend himself even though him is a convicted murderer? You understand what I say?
I think the case was really a peculiar one, in that we were of the view at the time that there were a number of things being done to try and influence the outcome via the media.
Yeah.
And we had expressed our concern from the very outset, if you remember, when the matter in fact was at Halfway Tree.
Mm-hmm.
There were concerns, and there were in fact open statements being made in open court.
Yes.
About a body being found in his yard. You remember that?
Yes. Yeah.
That wasn't true. You had this issue where they were saying that DNA evidence was had linked the deceased to the premises.
Yeah.
That turned out to be a lie.
Yeah,
So I think that you have to look at it on a whole. And you have a number of statements that are being made. And to my mind, when you have a charge which is as serious as murder, you should really leave that to the evidence. I don't believe that the system should be seeking to influence the case one way or the other.
Is it that when a man is charged for murder and prosecuted for murder, and you say something else about him, is it that him have any right for say you really slander him name, so I'm going to bring a charge against you for slander him name, or that look here, you're done in a prison already, you know, shut your mouth. You're a damn criminal, so shut your mouth. You don't have no right to come now talk about say, because a man say you might finger if you're 100 murder, you're going to now bring a case against the man. Is the citizen who get charged for murder of any another right again?
So in a nutshell, I think the question that you're asking is, you having been charged,
yes,
and even convicted,
yes,
do you no longer have a character worth defending?
Yes, that may
in other words,
yes,
does your right to defend your good name end?
Even if you don't have a good name now because you get convicted?
Having been convicted, does your good name end? I don't think so. And I think that in this case where he has appealed the conviction, I think that people need to be very careful with making pronouncements that they can't substantiate.
Yes.
That is my view. And we have always said, I mean, you can look at or listen to any interview or look at anything that we have said, both in court. If it is that this is the case, if it is that you are saying that he is responsible for all of these murders, then put him before the court for it. Charging for it.
Because I need to find out if a man can just say that so and just get you out of here. And if me said something on the radio, when me know as a truth, me have to go through us as a rigmarole for go find out if they're going to sue the radio station, if they're going to sue me, if they're going to go to prison, and if the radio station is going to lock down. And a man can just say that so. And it just go in at the ear and that is that.
I think that's an interesting point, Namuta, because I think that you really have a double standard in terms of the whole freedom of speech concept, where, you know, you may be saying something and trying to draw on the age-old adage of well, there is freedom of speech. You can talk your mind.
Yes.
And if you're not telling any lie, then what's the problem? But you might be brought to bear the consequence of that. But you have other people who say things.
Yes.
And don't feel like, you know, that should apply to them. They can say whatever they want.
Yeah.
But you, on the other hand, mustn't say certain things.
Because they're on the radio and they're going to libel them and slander them.
There you have it.
Well, so how far this thing has reached now with filing this suit against the man who said no? How far?
Well, as I said, I'm not the attorney who had...
Oh, you're not the attorney for that?
Who had filed that, no.
Okay, so that's
I wouldn't be in a position to indicate, but I do know that in the early stages I saw documents that were drafted. He had signed some documents in terms of instructions to the attorney to bring a case against not only the commissioner of police at the time, but other high-ranking officials who were making statements about and pronouncements about his guilt or innocence and his involvement, because you do remember there was another statement that had come out that he was responsible for essentially informing the police the whereabouts of some 16 or 17 guns,
persons
were taken into custody. So, but I think that if you assess carefully when certain high profile people are taken into custody, you can see that there is a trend where they try to. They try to essentially mar that person's image, in that you hear that when he was arrested they were crying, or you hear that they were, you know, them bawl like a baby, so this big bad man was
big man bawl like a baby, I wheel up himself.
Right, you hear that. I don't think that this is any different. In other words, you know, once in custody for this, you hear that, well, you know, really he should be in custody because he's responsible for all of these things.
Yes, and
that he's responsible for, I think there were some suggestions at some time that he was sending threats from his cell and that they had found all of these cell phones.
Yeah, well, you know, I did have threats, you know, because I say, Why, if one man respond, it look like five guys that try to kill out the whole of Jamaica. If one man can finger for 100 murder, me answer, wait, how would that duty and demon rats I look like? At any time, them can come for me to a 101 person. It's really amazing. I never hear nothing like that. That should be the greatest serial killer our man in the whole entire Western world. That's all. You don't see, because I don't know man where fingered for 100 murder in America. And America, the most murderous country. You know? But anyway, we're going to watch it still. We're going to watch it because, as we had said, we don't really like let go these things just so. Because when it's hanging out of the air, people need to find out if law and justice work together hand in hand. You know,
and if you remember, you know, our argument from day one was all we really wanted was a fair trial. You know?
Yes,
that really was our position, because it could happen to my kids, it could happen to yours, it could happen to, you understand?
Yes,
we are that person for whatever reason or whatever belief they have.
Yes,
or whatever profession they have, or the way in which they carry themselves, or, you know, in this case, the message that they are sending. Mm. You have a situation where that person end up before the court and kind of get a fair trial.
Yes, yes.
So I think by and large, what attorneys really strive for,
yes,
is that your client gets a fair shake.
Yes.
And if it is that your client, you have the view that the client has gotten a fair trial and they are found guilty, then so be it.
All right, well, we're going to call you and find out the lawyer who filed the lawsuit against this man who claims that Vice Arsenal killed 100, liable for 100 deaths. So,
yeah, man, no problem. If you give me a day, I can put my hand on the information.
Yes, yes.
And I can get that to you.
All right, thank you, Mr. Finster. I don't know if I must call you Mr. Finster or Christian, you know, because I took Finster in one.
All right, sir. Christian is fine. We talk.
So you is Christian and him a turn Muslim. What a thing. All right. All right, sir. Give thanks.
You can go on.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Yes, that was Christian Tavares Finson, one of the lawyers who represented Vibes Cartel. We just try to find out about his statement that was made, that Vibes Cartel is fingered for 100 murder out there. And we did really want to find out from him, can somebody really just say that so, and that's the end of it? Because I know feel say, if I didn't say certain things, and maybe I can't call the name of the person, you know, and I know, say, if I start to call the name, so my lady upstairs, I go start getting nervous if she upstairs. But I can tell you, say, you have a man, an ambassador in a Jamaica, who was murdered by a gay youth, and I used to live on the road below Theme Road, and on the road there, at night, any given time of night, you can come out there and see a whole, just like how you see the little boys, them full up Nutshot Boulevard, so, and then you go there at night time. It's the same way them used to stand up, down at the spot, this man I used to live, and them find out, say, him did have a whole heap of boys in there, panel tape, when I do certain things with. And it was going on from in a church days, choir boy days. And he was a big, big ambassador in a Jamaica, yeah, till somebody kill him. So I really like find out now, if at the time, given that he knows certain things, I will figure out it, because I know say, if I come on the radio and ball out him name, say that man there is a what them call it? What a decent word them call them people? Sodomite? A decent word that? Decent sodomite or a decent word? All right. Did you say sodomite or a decent word? Well, no, if a man that sodomite, who's a Gomorrahite? Because Sodom and Gomorrah two city, you know? It's a twin city, you know? It's a Sodom and Gomorrah. We never hear nobody talk about Gomorrah yet. Who did he have Gomorrah? I'm a pure lesbian. The man them, they are Sodom, and the woman them, they are Gomorrah, and God just lick out the whole of Sodom and Gomorrah. But I'll tell you, you know, say, me go down there already, do you? Me go down there, you know? Down at Sodom there, you know? Yeah, man, we passed down there one time and appear. Me don't know, the city, you know, sitting out there, they know, still, you know, but the mark of the city still there, they might say nothing can happen this again, because God strike it down with all sort of weapons of mass destruction. But whenever you nobody mention Gomorrah yet, always Saddam, Saddam, Saddam. So I said the decent world is not sodomite then. What you call them? Homosexuals. Homosexual is a nice word. Yeah. It is preferred. Homosexual. What I'm to gear.
What am I
word? Yeah, you can't say gear and you can't say homosexual. But better yet don't say Saddam. Yeah. Even though Saddam was a city and the people them who live in Saddam were the sodomites. It don't mean say the whole of them was homosexual. It just means say the city near, it's like Lesbos. There's a little island off the coast of Italy named Lesbos. You know what the people them from Lesbos is called? Lesbians. But the people them, most of them don't understand a lesbian. I can't tell the terminology go. So yeah, we have to really watch and careful. Cause you can't go to Lesbos and say, you mean you're pure lesbians there? So, and they're gonna say, yes, we are all lesbians. We are from Lesbos. Ah, oh, God. Stepping Razor. Yeah, this is the Stepping Razor, the Art of War. It's something I want to bring up right now because I don't know how much people recognize we are going in Jamaica, but it seems as if there's a kind of unholy dictatorship we have developed. Not only in the government, but in the so-called opposition. Now, we mentioned it last night, we're going to mention it again because I don't feel like I can mention it enough. The House just passed a bill authorizing the public money, to deal with political parties. That means they're going to take our money and help political parties, any party will sign up. Maybe we suggest that everybody should have to sign up as a political party because maybe that's the only way you're going to get money now. Because the PNP, I want if Asta Black under that regime too, because them claim say if he's a political party in Jamaica, you have right to public funds. Now I hear K.D. Knight get up in the house and say, look here, him can't agree with that. K.D. Knight say, look here, even if Jamaica was in a good standing monetarily, him still wouldn't agree with it. Him not agree if he take public funds and really help political parties in Jamaica. And with all of that, them still pass the bill in the House of Representatives. I don't know what them kind of representative for. But my question is this. That when we did hear the last election, we heard of so much young blood. This young blood in our politics supposed to do things different. This young blood going to bring a new enlightenment to the political affairs of Jamaica. These young blood going to make things be so different that we won't yearn for the old time we have politics again. Yet still, these young blood sit down in a parliament and vote in a bill to take poor people money for help them political parties. That is highway robbery. That worse than NHT. You know, I want to help people to understand where I go on. That worse than the NHT. Because them bail out them friend with the NHT money. And right now we see them going to take the money again and fund them political agenda. That's why I said the whole of us form a political party, because maybe that's the only way we will get money again from government. Are some serious criminal, them in Rasta. These people are some serious criminal. Look on where Jamaica is. There is more poor people now in Jamaica than before, according to the statistics. Picnic still their toilet. Picnic still their school. I use pit toilet. The road them in a dip. Hey, watch a man. Me want to know why is it that year in year out, is the same old them where them fix open back when rain fall. This, there's no new old. Some of them go by the sidewalk till you know. Some of the old them reach by the sidewalk and when you come, them jump out of the middle of the road. Because I drive through the junction the other day and me the feel that I know every old two junction. And it look like one of them wait by the sidewalk and when the motor coming or jumping on the middle of the road. And when I jump on the middle of the road, boom, I can't go right at the bottom of the patrol and I say, no, that's girl, where the patrol they come from. I went up last week when I drive the patrol, they never did it. But me, I tell you, say, they might use yard now for make for turn a yard now. They might use to fix the road, you know. Yard now can't fix road, Rasta. Oh, yard now for go fix road. And then now you give a man the contract for fix road. And that's why I know them people are criminal, you know. You give a man a contract for fix the road. And you know, have a man to go back, go look. About how him do the road, because him just put some asphalt in the middle of the hole and spray some tar on it and roll it over the road fix. Guess what? A madness, because every hole, that the rain start fall again, every hole we meet them fix, start dig up again. And then you have some new one. Come here, little one. Why is it that the hole them always depend on the side of the road? You know why? Because when them make the asphalt, them don't set up the side of the road that no water no seep into the side of the road. And when them seep into the side, hey, I wonder if these people know, say, the junction road right now, in a, they might wait till a car go over, you know, because what happened now is that the road take time, a broke away from the side, and the people them keep putting bamboo to protect the driver from make a curve inside of the road. There's about two parts of the road there, you know, where you see when you go round and another man come round, trust me, it's either you have to reverse or the man have to reverse, you know, because make sure you're on the side of the hill there, you know, because if you're not on the side of the hill there, believe you me, you see if you don't know say that there, and you go round the corner there, right at the edge of the road, you gone over the precipice, then I chuck go over there, you know. That idea chuck go over there, chuck go over there, because I don't know how them chuck man they manipulate the chuck them for go around them corner there, you know. But I realize it's the same old them are fixed. One to the man who's supposed to go and figure, say, well, you're supposed to put that amount of gravel, that amount of tar, you must roll it that time and then do whatsoever. Can somebody explain to me why is it that the same old year in, year out, every time rain falls, the same hole open up. The same hole open up. And these people get money. Them get aid. Them get grants. Them get all sorts of things. The road still no work out. Picnic still I use pit toilet at school. The job hard forget. People now want to create, that's why I have to big up the dance of them downtown, because them figure out a way of it, come out of the madness. You soon say police and police are get them hell still. I just show them maneuver themselves easy and know if you go around corner and all them things there. You know, see it? And I want to tell the girl them, you know, don't give the police them no sex, you know. Don't give the police them no sex, because that them are pressure all the woman them for more time, you know. Yeah, some that you think I lie me, I tell some that and tell me that. From that, I tell me that, say, the police, them, I pressure them, because them want to know where them live, and where them hang out at night time. I tell you, the corruption deep, you know, that's that. The corruption deep, but you know, that's it. Meanwhile, all of these things happening in Jamaica, with the road one, this and the road one, that, I mean, gas gone down 30% since the year start. We not see no serious dent in our gas vibe at the pump. Where all the money they there? If gas gone on 30% for the year, where all the money they there where the government has saved and them still collect taxes and all them something and them get money from the IMF and Peter Phillips are come on and I say, yes, just wait a little longer, you're going to see what's going to happen. Things are going to get better, things are going to get better, things are getting worse. The same way of Jamaican people feel last year, them feel same way this year. We don't want to accept that. We don't better accept that. So when one of you won't get up in the house and say, it's a shame. It's a shame upon the house. If you actually talk about public funds must contribute to political parties. And you still vote to legislation. Look how quick that got through. Look how quick them bring that as legislation. But them still linger upon the ganja thinking. We don't see them talk about the rest of them who get arrested for ganja over the years. We don't see them talk about the decriminalized. We see them talk about it as a matter of fact. Allow me to tell. We shouldn't see them not talk about it. Them are waiting upon the nearest part of the election to come. If you come bust it out upon the people, then you have some little idiot rasta start run behind them and have to see there. Government have a legalized ganja, we have to vote for PNP, vote for PNP. A rasta them a try catch, just like how Michael Manley did catch the rasta them with him rod of correction. When same get for Isla Selassie and not go so. Him put him picture and put Isla Selassie picture beside one another. And that's how them a Joshua, when we go lead the people them, which part Moses let off and him go come back. And now we see them a come back with the same thing and use ganja as a ply if you catch the people them. Rasta, you know, watch yourself, you know. I tell you for a long time, they must see if the ganja see them. Because Monsanto is after the ganja plant now. One if you hear me say. Me say, that big multinational corporation, we are trying to control seeds in the world. It's after the ganja see them. I mean, you have something called frightened Rasta. Two white guys come down and go out like see them grounds and love reggae and love Bob Marley and come up at them yard and say, oh, so where's your seeds for that beautiful ganja? And say, oh, boy, me I tell you, you know. So judge, I say, I don't know enough to really deal with color, so I know deal with no color, you know. So whether you're black or whether you're white, you know, the two of we are one. That's why the white man don't get in my heart and say, yeah, brother, we know we are all one, man. Judge us the far right. Where's the good ganja? And him just go on and eat him bed and take out the seed and say, oh man, wow, you saved these seeds from a long time? Say, yeah. Say, okay. Can you give me a little packet of it? Him say, yeah, man. Give you a packet of it, just give me $100. Him say, no, man, I give you $200 for the packet, man. Him say, okay. $200. That's a little rascal man. A long time him do it, $100, much less, miss $200. Him want to give you the whole bucket of ganja seed. And guess what now? It's a little Monsanto man, them send. We twist up him ear from before him reach us so. I have a little beard. And I've had a little red, gold, and green belt. With a Bob Marley t-shirt upon him. And got orange, he'll go Westman and go tell the dresser, yeah, man. Yeah, man, I know you got the best ganja down here, man. Want some seed, man. Yes. I tell the rest of them, you know, beware of Greeks bearing gift. Beware of Greeks bearing gift. Cause them catch you not this little one love, one heart, let's get together and be alright, something. Everybody are sing one love, one heart, let's get together and be alright. Before them sing Babylon system is a vampire sucking the blood out the sufferer. And you have some little lax brethren who out of their own heart very naively. I say, well, you know. I'm not looking on color, you know. Whether you're black or whether you're white, you know, we're all one in the Lord's name. Think the white man, I think that. The white man want the ganja seed. Monsanto control. We are telling you that. Monsanto are come for the seed, them. Think it's what me, I make? Monsanto are come for the ganja seed, them. So watch it. When you see some guy in a some Bob Marley t-shirt with him little year long down over his shoulder, and I talk about they love reggae music. Watch it. Them come like thief in the night. Like Santa Claus, that damn little pedophile brother who come every Christmas I come and take with the picnic them. Don't trust your picnic them with Santa Claus. Him is a pedophile. Click it. Yeah, this is the Stepping Razor, the Art of War. We're there with you. Every Thursday we're there, so believe you me. Every Thursday. So
until there is first and black unity, we cannot think of being acceptable to others until we have first proven acceptable to ourselves.
King Fragrance talking about black. Black light. So we want to play this next song, yeah. Lee Scratch Perry get nominated on the Grammy again. I tell you, man. You know, we go to Lee Scratch house and you look at it in bed, you see the Grammy Award laid on the bed. I tell you, no easy, you know. You got at least scratch house, and you open one room, a peer bird, a fly up and down in the room. It's not easy. Anyway, Lee Scratch Perry, back on the control with the album, Grammy nominated album. You want to track them, you know.
Thank you.
empty at the earwall. Still relevant in the reggae business, reggae music. Get nominated and win Grammy. Many, many times him get nominated. Lee Scratch Perry, one of the first producers of them pay. The Wailers. Outside at Studio One. Scratch Perry, man, nominated in the Grammy this year. Yes, the things them easy. Dub Wise, watch your speaker, watch your speaker. Yeah, the time is 1 minute past the hour four. Back to the man called Lee Scratch, Dub Wise. What a sweet music. What a sweet dub. Rasta on Wall Street, Lee Scratch Perry, nominated in the Grammy. Yes.
provoking, always smoking. Lyrics by Papa. You are listening to Muta by Muta.
Rasta snuff, hear me no stuff.
Hey, no. When you get your 15 minutes, make sure say you know where you are doing it. No slide on, slip it and go aim and go miss it. Cause I want life you have, so make sure you live it. Things with them in a this year rebellion, no in it. The love of Rastafari, we have to live it. Fight off wars and a love we use, win it. Plenty love of where we get and from we get it, we have to give it. Solid foundation, we all have to build it. Dreams and aspiration, man, no make nobody kill it. Promises and prophecies, we have to fulfill it. Every second, every minute, we commit, so we definitely. Don't have a vision, we surely go and perish. Good enough people, it will speak to that way of a cherish. That you don't have no hook, no verse, it don't have no topic. Only could I find it, vibe it, rhyme it, write it in the traffic. We grow the best, down at the west, fresh and organic. Fruits and vegetable, man, we take it like tonic. The way the rhythm ya move, man, me can't overstand it. Look like it at the baddest thing on the planet. People they must say, nothing we no edit. Half a big up Kirkle Dove and give him some credit. Don't ever be, don't bother be astonished. We lose some, we do some, battles we have won it. We'll never be no other me, you never see how we apply it. And a 1, 2, 3, and a do re mi, and a XYZ, no try it. Better you stop, no go to the shop, cash can't buy it. Your mind even bad, your heart even glad, you still can't deny it. Never you go ever be no dog to your vomit. You are not a puppet, worse not a comic. Pull your pride up high and never make them step on it. If them get the chance, they make you sink like the Titanic. Pull up it, dig pit, make them go and dig it. Put them dig too, cause them can't go in it. Why reap where you never sow? That's how you finish. Never plant a seed, but you won't cut me spinach. Can't spoil me character, can't touch me image. Special DNA from a royal lineage. Ancestral protection, cross all the bridges. Elohim, heal the king, we know who him is. When people come around, scrutinize them. Have ulterior motive and behave like a friend. When them get where them come for, that mission end. Check with themself, you not see them again. You never know where them a go like do re mi fa sol la si do. Don't give me no all for show like no eeny meeny miny mo. Move like an in your up, up we go like torpedo. Burn ego so we grow bite no hands that feeding yo. Hush blaze the chalice in a Buckingham Palace. Bob Marley say I am shot down the sheriff. Warriors don't cry chairman at the board berries. Heart full of love no have no space for malice. Everybody nowadays have the latest gadget. When them be looking at the mirror them a judge it. All kind of filthy things become them a bit. But the laws of nature man it just not go have it so. When you get your 15 minutes, make sure say you know where you are doing it. Just slide on, slip it, and go here, man. Go to sit down, one life, wait, so you know where you are doing it. Whoa, 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 whoa,
whoa. You are listening to Muta by Muta.
Whoa, yeah. I wake up in the morning, what? Gunmen standing over me with their guns and their babies. They cry, oh no, people have a feeling. They shout, oh, what we all are revealing. He was, he was. It was the city of my feeling open my eyes that I can see. What is over me? It was the city of my feeling open my eyes and save me. Ooh, from gunmen standing over me with their guns and their babies. Me cry, oh, oh, people are gonna feel it. Me shout, oh, oh, me all are reveal it. What? 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 What?
can see what is over me. It was the Savior, my only hope in life. And save me, oh Lord, from gunman standing over me with their guns and their bait. They cry, oh, oh, people have a feeling. They shout, oh, oh, she all are in me. Hey, 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 boy, boy, boy. Boy, boy, boy. Because the world is gone, they don't know what to do. Listen to me, what I say to you. The people in the South, they don't know who to choose. Even if they listen to the headline, yes, it's gunman standing over me with their guns and their babies. They cry, oh, oh, people have a feeling. They shout, oh, oh, they all are revealing. Hey, 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 boy, hey, boy.
This the lyrical assault of this Wellinka Equinox and then boss when him give bugger, give me a rhythm and some of a slaughter it. You see me bum with what I want, you feel come listen and speak up the bass pan it. The words in my flow and the water, this and the message them solid like when Malta mix up with water, pixel with the pastor, miss tell your son and your daughter don't fall for tricks.
a flipping it faster, ripping it faster than when the drug back kicking a free kick. A race one all done a pretty thing when the kingdom a scratch. Yeah, let you be go quick, make them alter, rip and them falter quick. Them the smarter, bit by me don't talk, them a jump off a cliff. Have the power like no one at the arc a gift. Don't flash, it's like when the smoke off a spliff. Then we laugh at it, hark and spit. When the fruit cause all of them talk and leave them stop like you in an alpha.
We not beg nobody pass. Baby rap music, I chop it up fast. We not beg nobody pass.
Yes, musical interlude. Yeah, man. I give you a breath of fresh air. You know them here, eh? Yes. Make your sickle down. In the day, yeah. It has to look like night, but we know it's a day outside. But by the time we come out, just know we go outside, it's a night. It's a terrible thing. When you left a place and you see bright sun hot. And you come in a place that look like night. That way you go back out and the sun hot, you expect sun hot and appear light. Car light, you see. Anyway, I saw it go. We there with you. Yes, Stepping Razor. We there with you. So, we did that say, oh, the party them, or oh, them make, let them pass it in the house for rob Jamaican people money by funding them political party. The weirdest thing, you know, is like, you fund the party if you oppress you. So they might take your money. It's like you're your own enemy, you know. you elect some people for do the right thing. And them there they do the wrong thing. Now them take your money now for fund them for do more wrong things. And where we're going about it? Nothing. Okay. So you know, say Ebola is a thing where the lips are whole heap of ones, and there's a forum organizing Ebola education forum that's trying to meet up Ebola health healing, and this is on December 16th. We here have my little Gambian friend. How you do? Yeah. How you do, my little Gambian friend?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
She laughs. Look at Gambia, I'm afraid. Because you know?
It takes me back to Gambia.
Ole Matital. Ole Matital. The lady who is from Gambia, is from Atlanta, is from Jamaica, is Sierra, England. I mean, wow. Leave a place. All right. So, tell me, explain to Jamaican people, what is this Ebola Education Forum?
Well, we've come together under the banner of the International Coalition of Unity and Healing to organize a forum and a live jam session. It's called Using Music as a Tool for Social Change and Destroying the Myths of Ebola, Health, Healing, Music, and Arts. It's going to be on Tuesday, December 16th at Nanook, 20 Burlington Avenue, which is down the street from Weddy Weddy Wednesday.
All right, so let me ask you a question. When you say destroying the myth of Ebola, what is the myth of Ebola?
Well, you know, right now, because of a lot of the propaganda that's out in the media, et cetera, a lot of people are afraid to go to Africa. It's affecting tourism in West Africa. Specifically, it's affecting importing, exporting, business, and even just the whole stigmatization of Africa at large. Mm-hmm. So what we want to do is just clear up what is going on around the Ebola situation, make people understand that Ebola is only in the three countries that it's been contained in. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yeah, man, yeah, yeah.
Okay, that is only in those three countries, and it has been contained in those three countries. They were other areas where there was Ebola in Senegal and Nigeria, and they got rid of it. So we're just trying to make people understand that, you know, Africa is in a healing process right now. We're trying to do everything that we can to eliminate and eradicate Ebola in those three countries. But in the meantime, the diaspora, African diaspora, Africa needs us right now. They need us to come together in unity to provide not only just economic support, but emotional support. Spiritual support, physical support. So that's what this forum is about, is to bring forth the topic to the forefront, but not focusing on Ebola, but how do we begin to heal, and how do we begin to unify and support our sisters and brothers on the ground in this crazy time.
All right, so tell me one of the ways that this organization choose to what we call get rid of the myth about Ebola. I mean, apart from, you say it's a forum. The forum, what the forum entail? What happen at this forum?
Well, from 6 to 9 p.m., we're going to have a number of different speakers that are going to be speaking about the issue. We've invited different people from the health sector to come and speak. We have also the World African Diaspora Union is sending a speaker from New York. They just recently had a same type of forum at the Morehouse, at Morehouse College, which is a very big black college in Atlanta University, for the students, and around the same thing, you know, destroying the myths of Ebola, and just trying to put Africa back in the forefront and looking at Africa from a positive perspective. So they will be coming down here and speaking as well. They're leading a large international initiative to raise funds and work with organizations on the ground in West Africa who need support. There are little things like Ebola kits that people need. I know people have seen news where some of us are dying in the streets and just left there dying because people are afraid to touch their bodies, because that's how Ebola is transferred, through the touching of sick people, or through body fluids of people who have Ebola. So because they don't have the proper kits and the proper equipment or the proper staffing, some of these people just end up, you know, dying or just sick on the street. Yeah. So we want to support them in every effort that we can. And so one of the things that happened is a friend of mine who's a major producer in the United States, his name is Echo Slim. He recently finished touring with a group called Black Violin. They performed at the President's Inaugural Ballroom a few years ago. But he donated a rhythm that we named Bio Warfare Rhythm, and we've been voicing artists since August. Recently we voiced Nadine Sutherland on the rhythm. Sizzla is supposed to be recording. We've sent letters to Akon, Ludacris, Neo Hakim, Les Nubians, Indy Irie, and just Chronix, Janine, Idonia, you know, everybody, different artists here in Jamaica as well, to be a part of this, and internationally. And all of the fun, all the sales from the mechanical sales are going to be donated towards organizations in West Africa that need help. So one of the things that we're going to be doing at this event is letting people get a sneak peek on the music project, what it entails, and some of the recordings that have been made, and we're hoping to drop it in a few weeks. So that's just one. The second is the speakers. And then just looking from a healing point of view, I think when we look at Jamaica and music and reggae music has always been a strong tool to heal and serve as a form of unity, inspiration for the whole world. And I think that by bringing together the players of the music industry and the reggae industry, by bringing together the youth leaders, by bringing together the media, we can go on a major campaign, whether it be through our music, whether it be through our daily discussions, whether it be through educating our young, just about bringing some holistic healing around this whole situation. And I think word, sound, and power is very important. Yeah. What we put into the universe and what we put into through our words becomes real. It becomes energy. It becomes energetic. So when we sing songs about healing and about unity, it can manifest into reality. And that's what I believe. And okay. So I use the power of words, sound, and power. I use the power of NOMO. That's what it's called in Ghana. Okay. The power of NOMO to heal. The power of NOMO to unify and to bring us together as a people. My family is in Gambia. Yeah. I have family in Senegal. I have friends that are living in Sierra Leone and Liberia. And I have my friend that I went to prom with, my high school classmate in Atlanta, now lives in Guinea, Conakry, and with his family. One of my mentors, Kwame Ture, also known as Stokely Carmichael, he died in Guinea, Conakry. That's where he was based.
Yeah, he was living there.
Yeah, he was living there. I was the last person I interviewed him before he left from America to go and live in Guinea before he passed away. But he had been living there for years and years and years. So Guinea, Conakry, you know, is a very special place for not just me, but for many of us.
All right, remind the people them where this thing going to keep again. It's Burlington, 20 Burlington Avenue.
It's going to be 20 Burlington Avenue.
December 16th, so what day? What day that is?
It's Tuesday the 16th. It's a free event.
Okay, start 6 p.m.
I want to also just highlight a lot of the people, because it's a team. I'm just a voice, but it's a team of us. I want to give a shout-out to
you. We have to go to the music news. So all we just want to remind the people them where it's going to keep and when it's going to keep.
20 Burlington, December 16th, 6 p.m., Sankofa Sessions.
Yes.
Let's do it at Caribbean Media, Mellow, and everybody, World African Diaspora Union, yes. Echo Slim, Amani
Fanation. Destroying the myth of Ebola, health, healing, music, and arts.
That's right. That's the
topic of it. Okay, give thanks. Yeah?
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Give thanks. Yeah, that was Olamate talking about project that she's working on, the International Coalition for Unity and Healing Forum, destroying the myth of Ebola, health healing music and arts, December 16, 2014. May I give the man a time for putting in the jump drive, so we could go and read it. 20 Burlington Avenue, and who I know that very important, very, very important. So as we say now, music news. 4:30 music news. Money.
Attention radio station.
Welcome. Please back away from your radio. I like new music, news talk, updates with artist drops, listener drops,
sound effects,
and movie drops.
Hey, what's that?
Music news.
Local.
Music news.
International. Welcome to music news.
It's the news time.
Welcome to Music News. It's Thursday, December 11, 2014. I'm Monique Price.
Yellow Moon Records.
Dancehall promoter and businessman Corey Todd was shot and injured in what is seen as a controversial shooting incident. IRFM's Michelle Scott gives us the 411.
Music News understands that at around 5 a.m. this morning, Todd and his security personnel were leaving his Taboo and Vanity nightclub in Montego Bay when they were pounced upon by two gunmen. It was alleged that there was an exchange of fire when Todd was hit by two bullets. One bullet grazed his head and the other shattered one of his arms. In the melee, one of the gunman was shot and killed, allegedly by one of Todd's security personnel. The other gunman escaped. Todd underwent emergency surgery to repair his arm. He is now in critical but stable condition at the Cornell Regional Hospital. There are speculations surrounding the incident, however. The Freeport police are investigating.
The name Corey Todd became popular in the local entertainment circle because of his previous management association with the dancehall artist Vibes Cartel. He was most recently in the news after having unceremoniously breaking business ties with dancehall artist Conscience and his sneaker brand Cons 876. Is it likely that Vibes Cartel will be suing former Commissioner of Police Owen Ellington? Allegations were made by the former commissioner that convicted dancehall entertainer Vibes Cartel is responsible for more than 100 murders. His former attorney, Christian Tavares Finson, in an exclusive interview with Muta Bruca on the Stepping Razor Today, asserted that Cartel is capable of pursuing a lawsuit for defamation of his character, even though he is in prison.
As I understand it, he has gotten a lawyer, and the lawyer has in fact filed documents speaking specifically to that already. That is my understanding of it. So the attorney who he would have instructed would be a civil attorney that specializes in those types of cases, and I understand, in fact, I did see documents that were drafted that would be in a bid to bring a case against those persons specifically.
Finson added that the burden of proof would be on the former commissioner if he is to successfully defend his allegations.
The person would have to essentially come and say, yes, we have proved that this person has committed 100 murders, and in fact, when we said so, it didn't affect his character negatively or in any adverse way. That would have to be the response.
Isaiah Leng, promoter of the annual Boxing Day stage show Sting, has not confirmed or denied the news of prize money being cut for the winner of this year's Major Clash. The reports have circulated that the prize money for the winner is $1.5 million, down from $3 million last year. The reports have also cited Joe Bogdanovich's departure from the partnership with Supreme Promotions event as the main reason for the prize cut. Speaking to Music News, Isaiah Leng says he will be providing an update as soon as possible. Sting has seen clashes with major industry players such as Beanie Man, Bounty Killer Movado, Vibes Cartel, Ninja Man, Kiprich and Merciless. Black Rhino and Kiprich clashed last year, however, Black Rhino took the title. Cloud still surrounds whether or not he will be able to do a rematch at this year's event. United fans, draw close or turn up your radio for the 411 on what's popping this weekend. On Sunday, December 14, make your way to the Lime Golf Academy in New Kingston for Euphoria, a charity concert organized by entertainer Mr. Vegas. There will be performances by 1980s international R&B band Champagne and R&B singer Karen White, alongside vocal Jamaican acts including Mr. Vegas, Freddie McGregor, Romaine Virgo, Christopher Martin, Christopher Dunzel, and Lati J. Euphoria concert will benefit the Mustard Seed Communities, MSC, a faith-based non-profit organization in Kingston. MSC serves over 500 children, young adults, and families who belong to the most vulnerable groups in society. On the international scene, singer Ray J's ex-girlfriend reportedly threatened to kill herself after pics of the artist was seen with him getting close to Chris Brown's on-and-off girlfriend, Karrueche Tran. A 911 call was made to the police after Princess Love called Ray and told him she is going to shoot herself. She later called him to say she would not go through with the suicide. According to TMZ, reports are that Ray J broke up with Princess Love after a huge fight on Tuesday night. The singer then went to a studio to shoot a New Year's Eve special for BET, and Karrueche was also there. They both hung out together until early Wednesday morning. This day in music, Jermaine Jackson and Curtis Williams are celebrating their birthday today. In 1964, soul singer Sam Cooke was shot dead at Hacienda Motel in Los Angeles, California. 1972, James Brown was arrested after a show in Tennessee for trying to incite a riot. In 2000, Lady Saw signed an agreement to join Shocking Vibes. And in 2003, Bobby Brown was charged with battery after allegedly hitting wife Whitney Houston in the face. That's the full 100 in music news for today, Thursday, December 11, 2014. Big up to recording engineer Tess Fopit. I'm Monique Price. Smoota, take it away.
I like new music, news talk, updates with artist drops, center drops,
sound effects,
and movie drops.
Hey, what's that?
Music news.
Local.
Music news.
Yeah, this is the Stepping Razor, the Art of War, there with you every Thursday. So, you know, so we're going to take some call, you know. We're going to take some call, even though the time kind of short.
And it's a protege, eh?
Yeah.
Chronics are where you stay, eh?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Who knows? Who knows? Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? This is the Stepping Razor, yes.
Muta.
Yes, sir.
I hear you talking about the bill that these people pass that we, the public, must fund their political party. And you know the travesty about it, Muta. The Senate, who most of the people in the Senate are not people that nobody vote for. They're by the two party. Right? They are, that means they are put there because of their alliance,
political agenda,
and their chartered alliance to the party. Why should these people make any decision in favor of us? And
yes,
then we do him have a talk.
Funding
in
them,
all of
yes.
It.
Funding them, yes.
Hmm? Is it fair to us?
No, it's not fair. The thing is that we know it don't fear. What are we going to do about it?
You see, Muta, you might not recognize who we're talking about. You see, I lied forum at you were the last time I was sitting on right beside you.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I look a brown shark man.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right? And I never get to thank you because the thing that you do that day, but I did like your poem then.
Yeah, but Michelle, I ask a question, you know.
Mm-hmm.
We know that we are going this, you know, not sound so right. So what we going to do about it?
You play your role.
Mm.
Yeah, you're talking about it now.
Yes.
Right? That means we are playing our role by speaking out against it.
Yeah.
Mm?
Okay.
Unless we are going to do something else more really, more serious.
Mm.
Right? We can't allow these people to just go out there, take us out in just money, do as they like with it, go, set up bills that affect us, and we can't even have a say in all of this.
Yeah, and the younger ones, them in the house, never do nothing about it, me about them more than vote for it, though.
Yes. No, and you can't say none of them is better, you know, because look here now. Some may say no, right? Some is going to say yes. Well, I must, Miss Malawu Ford, I don't know if her role was supportive or not supportive.
Well, KD Knight, Mr. Get Up and Talk Against It, you know.
She talk against it?
No, KD Knight.
Mm-hmm.
KD Knight, Get Up and Talk Against It. The only man, I don't know if anybody else, you know, but a KD Knight may get a strong, mm-hmm. strong vibe from, he said, no, I'm not allowed that. I'm not really into that.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess it was like a lone voice in the sequence.
Yes, because, and you know, so that don't go down well with this party when your party that you support is trying to put through a bill and you don't see it possible that not going to go down well. But when KD, he's not afraid of people.
Yeah, well, we don't know what happened as well now, because it looks like nobody knows nothing about it. We know you're not big alabalu agwan like
no, because Muta. A lot of us in this country are not prepared to stand up for what we believe in.
Mm.
And those of us who stand up, we come under a heavy fire because what? We are not supposed to do this because what? We are supposed to stay in chains and don't say anything.
Yeah.
Those of us who are in the house now and we like to know, yes, they are not enslaved again. They can't do anything. It's not fair.
Yes.
Before I go, Muta. The Tivoli inquiry.
What I was watching it today. What a travesty, man.
Yes, yes, yes. And I hear this young lady was talking, and I tell you, she break down. They have to cut it off about 20 minutes before she come back.
You mean a next woman cry? Her old lady cry yesterday.
Yes, yes. She sound like, she say about her son, that mean, you know, a big somebody, but she sound like a little girl, but a big somebody. She break down. They have to cut the thing off. It's a land. She got through all of this big liar them, but when Mr. Lan was asking her, it's as if the boy, he come back down and she break down. But my problem, Muta, with a situation like this, should be some form of a counselor there. That's when these things up, you can't take these people into hand and sit down and try and help them and make them understand, you know.
I put it to you, sir. That no police shot anybody in Tivoli Gardens and in the year 2010. No police got shot and or shot anybody.
But those are
no
police soldier. And soldier liar.
No soldier but shoot anybody in Tivoli Gardens. All the people them who got shot in Tivoli Gardens is the gunman shoot them.
And when you are going to say that to people who see soldier coming at them out, go upstairs, police and soldier, take out them family, murder them and all, no, you don't get to bury them. Can you tell me how these people can be able to go through this and live a good life after Muta?
Well, look here, man. It's a trauma that will never come out for the people them who experience it.
What about the youth?
There's no counseling for those people up to this day. No counseling. One and two.
What about the youth?
Go down there. But I don't. Why? I tell you,
the youth, them that grew up in that community. How are these youth going to grow up? Are they going to grow up with a serious vengeance on them? Are they going to grow up like some of a vegetable?
Well, we shall see. But I know, say, them are angry people, them like nothing, like what them are saying. No, I mean, I understand them are getting paid for the certain thing.
Yes,
but
blood
you,
money.
You who sit down there and I look upon this thing, I say, oh gosh, man, why you have to carry the people them through this thing enough to come prove what? What them trying to prove? That the police them never do what them did do, that the soldier them never them did do. All of the people them go up there lie and exaggerate. Nothing truthful now come out of the people them. I mean, really, man, really, really, really.
Muta, I've been down there. Mm. After the police, after everything finished and the police and soldier was there still,
yes.
I got down there, Muta, and you see what me say. My foot was weak just by seeing what happened to people.
Yeah.
When I go down there, I see people who the fright on their face. It's as if somebody just say a zombie. That's what I see when I go down there.
To this day, you can't see when the people them come to give them statements, you know, how them look, you know. You can't see them, you know, when
you
talk
to you
know. And
you meet this tall lady, right? You was there while she was talking, because I believe you didn't left. But she was this sitting right beside her, this thought lady.
Yes.
She give her statement since week, and I tell you.
Yes.
Boy, she is strong. She is strong. She is strong.
Anyway, we're going to see what happened, because, may I tell you, we're going
to see what happened.
Yes, sir. May I tell you, man, the people, them, I mean, when you get, if you never in there, you know, you can angle, go on like you feel the pain of them people there. But may I tell you, if a group of people now come after someone, if you sit down in front of a group, a liar, who get money paid to tell the people them who experience this dramatic, traumatic experience, that I tell you, sir, that no soldier chat you. And the people, they must just take that, sir. I put it to you, sir, that you were not shot by a police. And you say, but it's a police shoot, Mr. Mr. the policeman. And you ask the same question over and over and over. And if one little sentence is like different from the first time you answer, your ear says, liar, tell. My gosh, man, may I tell you, man, it's trauma. All me, I watch it get traumatized. Believe you me. Me, I watch it and I get traumatized myself. Yes, step in.
Uta.
Yes, sir.
Along the same thing. Well, sometimes I think it's only you serious about crime in Jamaica, because it's only you I hear a leak out. Because look how much people them and them murder this week.
You mean the gunman them?
Yeah.
Yes.
Mr. My God in heaven, this government came into power and they didn't one time, let's have a gun amnesty, let's take some guns out of the street.
But I can tell you something, the irony of it is that meanwhile, the minister was saying that crime gone down must be 15% or 16%. But four men get shot. Meanwhile, him attack. On the television.
I was observing that.
Yeah, but four men get shot, get killed. Meanwhile, they had say, gun, and if it was any other sector that marked 15% decline in certain things, you'd hear a lot about it. But why should I hear 900 people dead murdered since the year start, Regine? I mean, what feel good about that? Said gone down less than last year.
No, I hear you draw a reference to New York. You see, Mayor Bloomberg, people don't like him, but you said the stands of him take one gun in a New York.
Yes.
If he never take that stand, then New York would be like Chicago.
May I tell you, man, them people have them head in them. Round of them real, yeah. But I'm going to tell you, that's
what about that gun amnesty? Take off the gun, is either you arm everybody or disarm everybody?
Well, you know, yes, I can tell you, the illusion where, Peter, I'm going to tell you where the illusion where them in. You see, if this month you hardly hear anybody dead, them say crime gone down, but you know, the crime is the gun where the man them have commit the crime with, you know. If you don't get the gun them out of the man them hand, the man them can't sit down there and all a month them not really shoot nobody, you know, and then the next month you start them shoot everybody. Them have the gun still. There's no way a crime can go down and get rid of that. If the gun them will do the criminal, if the criminal them still have the gun them, no way.
It has to be, why Rasta know if me around a country, so much gun nada there.
But we know how we that beat, you know. But it's them people, you know. Look here, I said before, you know. You have Rwanda, you have Colombia, you have New York. New York have 10 million people in it. Last year, them have 300 murder. 10 million people in a New York, 300 murder. You have Norway are closed down prisons right now because the rehabilitation thing is so profound that them actually have to close down prison. The minister need to go to this country and find out what the hell these people is doing.
What make the thing go down for? Bloomberg, and trust me, he see, keep the guns off of your streets.
Why? Him need to go talk to the man. Him need to go there. Him need to go and you have to talk to them. You have a city with 10 million people and them have 300 murder. And you have a population with 3 million people and you have 1,000 murder in a 1 year. And then when 10 people are dead this month, you say, well, the police is doing a wonderful job. because we have recorded 10 less murders than last year this time. And you say, what the hell this man is, where am I being made? He is an acrobat. He can put him head in a place and turn him head in a some place where I'm not chicken gunia. Because if he did have chicken gunia, I couldn't turn him head certain place. I mean, I say, how the hell these people keep saying that it's because of the work that the police is doing why the crime gone now. It's not true. It's not true. It's the gunman them take arrest. Because the man who did kill the man last week, him still have the gun to kill a man this week. And if that man don't have the gun again, and you don't do some kind of rehabilitation, a total reconstruction of the whole thing. The same gun them, one gun and kill a whole heap of people, you know. A man just rent out all him gun, you know. You have people who rent gun in Jamaica, you know. Illegal gun too. Rental a gun a go on. Or a guy, just get a guy and just say, watch, I go eat a food with this. And make sure he say, bring back my gun, you know. Because if you don't bring back my gun, you are go dead too. You pick me, I go dead, and your family, I go dead. You know, see it. So, the gun up on the road, and them are going like say, because you don't hear four murder, you hear four less killing going this month, you start to feel good. Say, well, you know, if any other sector had 16% decrease in the murder rate, or 16% decrease in whatsoever, it would be a big thing, but just because it's crime. Well, I don't feel good. I still don't feel safe in Jamaica. And that's not how safe supposed to be. And now look how Montego be. Montego become like the murder capital in Jamaica. Yes, man a fire shot from Kingston and go through Fern Gully and reach a Montego be a kill people. It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing. Go on. Gonna buy now. Bullets can't go around corner now. Bullets not go straight again. Look at two man get shot. Now I'm going to be to that. Well, I'm more than two man because you have two people who are dead too. You have two people who are dead too. So I don't know. I don't rate them. I don't rate them when I talk about murder gone down. Believe you me. All right, I'm going to click it. Hey, the time is 20 seconds to 5 o'clock. And I was going to wait longer than it was 15, you know, but I saw it go anyway. It's a cash part business. I go on here, so now. You know, I buy a cash part, Neil? Not today. No, man, they must have about $200 million you can win, you know. If me ever win $200 million, I'm going to go up on the pool, go jump off, you know. Come in at your pool. Brand new album from Raging Fire.
Party for destiny. That we all be free. When we all meet at our homeland, Africa, where we come from. Where we come from. I look in the air. Hear what I say, yeah. What if our destiny is that we all be free when we all meet at our homeland in Africa, where we come from. Where we come from.
Yeah, Raging Fire coming through, man. Africa, where we come from, yes. Step in. Yes, step in.
Hello, Muta.
Yeah, blessed.
Margaret again. I remember Margaret and Carlos from Grandpa week before last.
Oh,
I was in Carla last week,
yes,
and I couldn't get to Carla. That's what
I mean.
Yeah, man, you see the thing that I'm going down at Tivoli. I feel it for them, you know. Because here we are going on. I have a son where crash off a bike and then, you know, and I have the only child I have, you know.
Mm.
And I have 2005 in it, all known. Me still feel it. At the program, me listen more time. Give me a little vibes, you know.
Yeah.
Like when me, I listen to you.
Yeah.
And Ron Musheta, Elise Kelly.
Yes.
And sometimes I call and then we're there. And them things that give me a little vibes. One time I call a man and say, he said, he's a pastor, asking me much fee do a counseling. He says it's 2,000 in charge for counseling. I said, well, I mean, I have the money there, you know.
Mm.
So I have to go and try fight it out. Because I find $2,000 twice a week for sit down and get counseling.
$2,000 a week, you have to give him?
Twice a week.
Okay.
$2,000, you know, each time.
Yeah.
So he said, no, sir, it don't make sense. That's too much, because sometimes I can't find money to buy food for much more. Figure.
Hello?
Like $2,000 every time to counseling.
Yeah. So you go and listen
so
to the program
there. So I feel it for the people in the valley.
I feel it for them, man. The more I look on it, the more I vex to you. Know.
And so I lose my son.
Yeah.
Now, accident, you know what is it?
Yeah. To lose a son. And you can't imagine your accident, your son get lost in a police shot for them picnic.
Mm-hmm.
And they have to turn up in front of some people and tell them, say a lie, they might tell.
Mm hmm.
You can't believe that, man. You're speaking against us and you have to slung in front of somebody to tell them.
My own accident in meeting, I can feel it so much.
Yes, yeah,
much more.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
So you're all right still, though? You're still going.
Yes, all right, yes.
Yeah, man, give thanks, yeah?
Yes, all right, Musa.
Yes. Yeah, man, it's a terrible thing, man. Police and soldiers shot your picnic and you have to slung in front of some people to tell you, say, a lie you tell. Strength you need, man. A whole heap of strength that you need. Believe you me. A whole heap of strength that you need.
We only be when we own these that are homeland in Africa, where we come from. Where we come from. So good.
Raging fire, yes, step in. Yeah.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
First I'm calling. About the war in Tivoli Garden. My baby father was still in Tivoli. But
2010?
At the time
2010?
At the time,
yeah.
My daughter was younger with him, but he leave her with a friend. And don't know what happened because I was there. And after the war and everything, when I got down there, and I said, I'm a first soldier. So I was speaking to him and said to him that, you know, that baby father dead and was there, right? Like, my baby father dead and whatever. We can't take it over. That was his remark. And I look at him and say, I'm not coming from the near end, so if I did you plan for the end, I get it.
When you tell him to your baby father, then when he said to you?
If him can get me.
Oh, he might look you.
Yeah, basically, where must so because, you know, when you're there, you must search back and so forth.
Yeah.
Some of the buy some panty and so.
Mm.
So I come by the underwear, then they say they love it and whatever.
Mm.
I come back from a baby, my ear should have come, mommy, bop, 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 bop. Anyway, since here, them have career day. And she said, mommy, I want to be a nurse. Just her up as a nurse, police and so forth come, and when they did that, talk, she said, I'm so, oh, she was the panty, killing. So we need to explain to them and say, when can she see police, then she run from them. Because if she said, she'll go out into the vehicle, first thing she had, if no one well, pan, she run right on the road.
She's free
that. Huh?
Where she run on the road for?
Because she's frightened for them.
Oh, she's afraid of the police them.
Yes, because basically I'm with she here. Me never tell her about at the time was she here.
Mm, so police kill her father.
Huh?
She here, so police kill her father.
Yes. So every time she see them, the car or something, she just all over the place and traumatized.
So you're counseling, you're getting into counseling? How old she's now?
She's five. Yeah, take her police speak to her and so forth, but it still affects her and so forth, because each time she'd ask my mama where is daddy and so forth, and she go to and say her father and did and him something. So
what the father name?
Reggie Miller.
Did you call him name last week?
Yes, you did.
Oh yeah?
Yes.
Wow. So when you hear me call him name, how you feel?
I must feel a way for no respect. Like, no, my house burned down and try to get a work, can't get it, and just me alone with her and so forth. So it's rough with me alone.
Terrible. And a whole heap of people like you in the same position down there, you know. I mean, you never live down there still, but the position of the people them is terrible, and then you have to now get traumatized again by going through this little courthouse business where they must set up down there, you know?
Yeah.
Terrible. Anyway, go on, hold on still, you know?
Okay, I have a pleasant evening.
Yes, give thanks. Yes, I know there's many cases like that. Many cases like that. The righteous on all. Believe you me. Stress. Songs of freedom, man. Yes, step in.
Mota.
Yes, ma'am.
Wagwan.
There.
How day? Wagalang now.
Me a galang.
Mm-hmm. You know, me have two relatives dead down at Tivoli there too.
Oh, yeah. Where you are called from?
St. Thomas, lady.
No, me no, St. Thomas, me have, but the other day you call in Westmoreland, you there?
Yes, no, me there back at St. Thomas, come and lose.
Okay, you lose, or the party lose, which one?
I'm the party lose.
Okay, so wait, you know, you have two people who dead on the valley?
Yes, and Beanie and Trevor kids. Yeah.
Did you call them name last week?
Yes, I guess so. I don't really know them name. I used to live down there, but a long time I don't go down there. But then I did see them coming up here, panting, and they come up here, because when my uncle died, they come up funeral up here.
So you feel when you see it on the TV, you know, where they might bring up the whole thing?
No, man, they feel bad, Mota. They feel bad when was am a relative and them dead down there too.
Yeah,
me feel very, very bad.
You know, whole heap of Jamaican feel away, you know, just like look, just hearing the people there.
Yeah, man, when you see it, your eye, they're full of water, Mota. Yeah, well, even here, when the little old lady cry, your eye full of water.
Yeah, I tell you, man. And then the people, them, have no kind of, well, them lie, they don't have no hard, because them, they have to make the soldier them look nice.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah,
true.
Make you feel like the boy, the soldier them.
I mean, I have a cousin, where live up here, see, I be a baby father, they down there too.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
I put it to you that you are lying. No police.
No, I'm not. You know that. No, you know that.
Me never know you have baby.
Not me with baby. It's my cousin baby father died on there.
No, me, you are baby. You're a baby in the background there.
I'm a granddaughter.
You are granddaughter.
Yeah.
You're serious?
Yeah, I'm a granddaughter, man.
Oh, so you're a Peggy. You're going like say you're old, but you're big woman.
Yeah, me 56 motor.
Then that's why I mean, that's why you love five.
Me a big woman.
That's why you love five or young, so because you make you feel young when you come.
Yes, it make you feel young, but the chick is still in my body. See I'm weird.
This you're serious?
Yeah, man. This man, anything I'm a foot them, I'm a hand them. I couldn't get to wash properly.
You're serious?
Yeah.
They no long time, they no long time have it, man. They no long time have it now.
Yeah, me have it over some of the 2 months now. I'm going to the doctor and give me some painkiller.
You have to watch how you take them antibiotics there now, because antibiotics almost, your body get immune to it and then something else happen.
Yeah, Muta, we have a drink of bush too now and then.
All right, mama. So,
yes. So you take care of yourself, Muta.
All right, mama.
I try come Sunday, you know, because one of my girlfriend telling me, say she come down there last week and down there had fell off.
May I tell you?
The man was there, so down there nice.
May I tell you, man?
Man, Lisa tell me, say she come down there, man, and down there fell off.
Yeah, we so have to go downstairs with it, you know. I don't know if the people, any more people can hold upstairs there.
That me, I say, Muta, yeah. Real nice.
All right. Yeah. Mama, give thanks.
Yeah, take care of yourself then, Muta. I love you.
All right, give thanks. Love you too. Yes. Okay, where were they? This one there? All right. Click it. Yes, step in. Yes, CN. Yes, that's it.
Afternoon, sir.
Yes, afternoon, man.
Yes, first time on the program.
Yes, sir, give time.
But it's all well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to talk about the people, especially IGL gas, you know?
Yeah.
You know, them are rob people, though. They are rob money, man.
Mm-hmm. Oh, them
not put no, them not put no gas on the pan, motor.
Them not put no gas in there?
No, no, them not put no gas on the pan, motor.
Oh, you know?
You don't have to kind of buy a gas on that. Almost empty
for the bar meter. They no wait. Yes. Them not have a way out there. Them not have a way out there. Can't wait.
Eh?
Them not have a way them call it. A weird thing where you can't wait.
No. And I don't have the
plant
to buy.
Oh, you buy it at a gas station?
No, buy it at the people who sell it at them yard.
Oh, the people who sell it at them yard?
Yeah.
You have to watch their yard business there, you know.
Too
much. You have to watch them, yeah. So you know another place where you can go buy it, since you doubt them people there. Maybe you should have changed the place where you buy it.
Yeah, me have other place where you can go, but too near to my
yard. Yeah, but you see, if you doubt them, yeah. I better you take the distance and go buy it somewhere else then.
That's true.
Yeah, stop buying from there, so since you doubt them.
That's true.
Yeah, you know.
Them now put no gas on the pan, Muda.
Yeah.
No gas on the pan to people,
money. Yeah, and that would I recommend to you, so you must stop going to go buy it then.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Yeah, good time.
Yeah. step in.
Yes, I step in.
Blessed man.
Muta.
Yes, sir.
I mean, you called about the battle last night with Ruby, you know?
Yeah.
Youth presenter, man.
Yeah, me remember.
Yeah. So, I ask yourself, me buy the battery, me put on a promotion.
Yeah, man, you say you never, get the battery. Me remember, no, you, man.
They don't get it.
Yeah, they don't know that you said last night. So, where you, yeah, where you do from last night till now?
What me do now, me go back and check the deal I done at the place. And he must say, boy, I must go contact them back to see if me can't get it. But me not get no good words from them with it, you know.
But what me tell you last night for do? What me tell you for do last night?
Yeah, me go around at the station and the police laugh off of me.
When me laugh?
Me go to the CIB office and the police laugh off of me, you see. That's the thing that joke thing me never. And me say, no. So it's like, you must show me no thing you can't do nothing to that.
You have to sue rubies. You have to sue rubies.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, if you get a liar now then.
That's too much work, man. Oh, we just have a lot of them with them things still. I know they have some fraud business they might deal with. That's me, I say.
No, but it's not.
Hearing with the wind, they give me a hearing, you know.
Yeah, but it's a truth. You know, you say what's going on. True, you say you have to get a liar now. You say you have to load them.
No, I can't get a liar.
But that's the problem now when you say you have a lawyer.
No, I don't have no problem because I can't get a liar.
Yeah, but if you get a liar, you no must have to pay for the liar. Them good have to pay for the liar too.
Okay.
You know,
well, that's what we can't deal with it.
Yeah, but you no must have, if them put you in a problem, that's all now. The judge can't, they say they must pay for your liar bill, you know.
Well, like I said, I'm not going to do that. I'm sure the company is with you.
Moon let it go. Moon let it go.
They allow them with everything.
But that means I said, so moon let it go, you know. Moon let it go. That's simple, but moon let it go.
That's you.
Yeah, so.
Well, I'm not taking care of it, Peter, and get a liar. Because I win my battery, you know.
Yeah,
I buy 2,500 out of gas.
Yeah, man, you said that. You said that. I remember you saying that. Yeah. So try get a liar and see what happens.
All right, my brother.
Yes.
Be cool.
Yeah, we want to give thanks to the time, give thanks to the moment, give thanks to the energy. You know, so we'll be back here next week, Wednesday, from 10 to 2 on the Cutting Edge. And then we're here on the Thursday again with the Stepping Razor, the art of war. So, I saw it go, you know, I saw it go.
Wake up and remember the fight of King Selassie I. Marcus God is said a long time. Up your might to raise a cup of what you will. My people, you are strong. Liberate the mind. We'll be right back.
spirituality through religion, provided by foreign invaders and conquerors. We must stop confusing religion with spirituality. Religion is a set of rules, regulations, and rituals created by humans, which was supposed to help people grow spiritually. Due to human imperfections, religion has become corrupt, political, divisive, and a tool for power struggles. Spirituality is not theology or ideology. It is simply a way of life, pure and original, and was always given by the Most High of creation. Emancipate. A network linking us to the Most High, the universe, and each other. Together we are one. We are strong.
Yeah, the time is 5:45 news time.
Live at 5:45.
Live at 5:45.
Comprehensive coverage of the news, sports, and entertainment of the day on IRFM, the leader in radio in Jamaica. Up to the minute, accurate, and non-aligned news package, plus weather, special features, and entertainment. Live at 5:45.
Good afternoon. It's Thursday, December 11. I am Natalie Campbell.
And I'm Primrose Oliver.
From IRFM's News Center, here are the headlines.
Mother tells Tivoli Commission of Inquiry she has not seen her 16-year-old son, Dale Davis, since May 2010.
PNP Councillor for Mount Salem Division of St. James Parish Council, Avery Rose Green, resigns.
Full cost of damage to roads and agriculture due to recent heavy rains in St. Mary yet to be tabulated.
Two premises in Ultra St. Anne raided by a coffee industry board team in search of illegal and unlicensed coffee.
Coming up in sports, Jamaican middle order batsman Marlon Samuels sparkled with unbeaten double century today on second day of 3-day tour match against South Africa.
Now the details. A mother told the Commission of Inquiry today that she has not seen her 16-year-old son Dale Davis since May 2010. The woman, Dawn Brown, testified that she lived in the Waterhouse community, but her son Dale stayed with her aunt in Building 5 in Tivoli Gardens. Halsheen Burke reports.
Dawn Brown testified that on Monday, May 24, 2010, she spoke to her son via telephone and he told her a war had broken out in the Tivoli Gardens community. She said she told him to stay inside and care for his grand aunt. Ms. Brown stated that she also spoke to him the following day, again telling him to stay inside. The mother said late in the week she went to her aunt's house and was informed that soldiers had taken her son away. She stated that she went to Upark Camp, the Child Development Agency, and the Alpha Boys Home and did not find her son. She added that she went to Madden's funeral home but was not allowed inside. Ms. Brown said she also heard from her sister that Dale had died, adding that she was unaware of any investigation into his disappearance even after speaking to the public defender about the issue. During the cross-examination, one of the attorneys for the Jamaica Defense Force asked if Dale was a troubled child, to which she answered no. She maintained that Dale was a good boy who took care of his ailing grand-aunt and had no criminal record nor had been suspended from school. Ms. Brown said she was told by someone from Indicom that her son was dead and that she hasn't seen nor heard from Dale since that Tuesday. Meantime, the first witness delivery man, George Harriet, said he was shot in the right arm when he went outside on the morning of May 25, 2010. Harriet lived on North Street. He testified that he spent 25 days in hospital because of the wound to his arm, which he maintains he still is unable to use fully. Mr. Harriet adds that he is still due for another surgery and is unsure how he will acquire the funds. The witness said he was told that he was shot by either soldiers or police from the direction of Tivoli Courts. He explained that he walked from his home to the Kingston Public Hospital. Mr. Harriet said he received about $75,000 in total following the shooting, with 15 coming from the Path office on Harbour Street and the rest he collected at the Tivoli Gardens Community Centre. Reporting for IRFM News, I am Hal Shane Burke.
Meanwhile, 41-year-old hairdresser and market vendor Rosalind Newton broke into tears as she recalled the treatment meted out to her by soldiers during the 2010 operations into Tivoli Gardens community. This led to a short break in this afternoon's session to allow her to regain her composure. Ms. Newton stated that she was at home with the father of her son and her nephew in Tivoli Gardens on the morning of May 24, 2010, when soldiers entered. She says around 8 soldiers told the 3 men to lie in the dirt. She states that the soldiers slapped the men before pointing their guns at them. She says she jumped between the gun and her family to prevent them being shot and that a soldier grabbed her by the neck and shoved her to the ground. She says she stood up between the gun and her male family members. She says after that, soldiers took them to a pathway where more men and women were told to lie face down in the mud. Ms. Newton says she saw a soldier kick her nephew, Luddy Murphy, in his forehead and that he began to cry as blood flowed from his mouth and nose. Afterwards, she said police directed her nephew to walk down Kirkpatrick Path before a police with a long gun pointed in that direction and she saw fire appear from the barrel of the gun. She says she could not distinguish gunshots because of the constant barrage of gunfire all around. Ms. Newton says she did not see Luddy get killed because of the distance. She says she did not see her nephew again until the day of his funeral in July. Ms. Newton, who was being cross-examined by attorney for the Public Defender's Office, Miguel Lorne, broke down as she recalled that day.
And you get up back, and when you get up back,
I get up back and go back opposite and same way, over.
You go back and position yourself over.
My son and my nephew and my baby father.
Yes. So you went back a second time.
Yes, sir.
Over them. You had also gone to the...
She's breaking out.
Probably we could take a 5-minute break, sir.
Ms. Newton, you want a little break now?
Following the break, attorney for the JDF, Linton Gordon, asked that attorneys show a sense of sensitivity to those appearing before the commission. He pointed out that while some of the witnesses' testimony were adverse to the JDF, the testimony was not challenged. The Army's attorneys, he asked the chairman to rule that where answers given by witnesses are not challenged, there's no need for attorneys to have the witness repeat testimony, leading to them becoming emotional. The commission chairman, Sir David Simmons, agreed.
It's an act of oppression and insensitivity for any other counsel to ask her to recite those and to become emotional and upset by virtue of that.
I think everybody has heard what Mr. Gordon has said, and all of us will agree with that. We appreciate that many of the witnesses coming to this inquiry are still psychologically scarred from the experiences of 2010 and will find it unpalatable to relive those experiences. Let us just remember that for some of these witnesses, and especially those who have lost relatives, this is a harrowing experience that we are putting them through, but it is necessary.
JDF Attorney Linton Gordon and Commission Chairman Sir David Simmons.